Hey there everyone, today we're going to make the world famous Mickey Waffles right here at home, and the most important piece of this whole thing is the Mickey Waffle Iron. Now you don't need to have a Mickey Waffle Iron, it's my favorite part of it, I'm glad I have this one. It's older, you can see, it's older, it's kind of beat up a little bit, but I still love it, and today we're gonna make waffles in this iron. Let's get started. Now the first thing I'm going to do is plug in our Mickey Iron, and that way it'll get nice and hot and it'll be ready for us once the ingredients are all mixed together. Okay, it's plugged in and it's heating up. Now before we get started, let's clear off a little space here. And there it is, lots of counter space. Now for the first step, I'm going to need flour, sugar, baking soda, baking powder, and buttermilk powder, which I have not used before in a Cooking with Michael episode. Now I know a lot of family members and friends who would like a taste of these Mickey waffles, so I'm gonna be doubling the recipe today. Now that means that if you wanna make them at home, you can either cut them in half, all the ingredients that I'm making, make the double, just like I'm making it, or follow the directions in the description of this video. Now the first step calls for 2 cups of flour, and since this is a double recipe, we're making 4 cups of flour. Now for the next step, we're going to need sugar. We need 10 tablespoons. The recipe calls for 5, but again, since I'm doubling it, we're using 10. And 10 tablespoons of sugar. Now this is where it gets a little tricky. I'm going to need 18. That's right, you heard me, 18 tablespoons of buttermilk powder. Recipe calls for 9, so I'm doubling that. That's a lot of buttermilk powder. Now I have tried this recipe without the buttermilk powder before. It does not come out as well. If you don't have it, I recommend you get it for this recipe. There are a lot of things I'm willing to change in recipes, but buttermilk powder is one of those things that I really do want to have. Okay, can I get 18 tablespoons out of this container? Let's find out. 18 tablespoons of buttermilk powder. I had to double check making sure it is tablespoons, not teaspoons, otherwise I was about to panic. Now we're going to add 4 teaspoons of baking powder, and we're going to add 2 teaspoons of baking soda. Make sure not to get the baking soda and baking powder confused. That is 2 teaspoons baking soda. Now this is the part where we can add malted milk. This is optional, you don't have to do this, but I really do like to add it. It really gives them that Disney taste. And you can vary this. This is between 4 to maybe 6 tablespoons of malted milk powder. I'm gonna try 5. Let's try 5, give it a try together, see how it turns out, and then maybe we'll add more if we need to. Okay, let's try 5 tablespoons. It might not be enough. It really might not be, and that's okay. This is just dependent on taste. Now we're gonna grab our handy whisk over here and just start to blend the ingredients together until they're consistent. We don't want to overdo it because we want all the ingredients to stay in the bowl. I'm going to whisk them up just a little bit and then we'll move on to the next step. Now this is a lot of waffles we're going to be making here. I can tell the double recipe is really going to make a lot of people full, and I wish I could send them to you in the mail. I really do, but I don't think they would keep. So I will be here and enjoying them, and then hopefully you give them a try at home. You let me know if you enjoyed them with this recipe. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Okay, that looks pretty consistent. Now we're going to set this aside, grab another bowl, and start working on the wet ingredients. Okay, now we're going to mix up the milk, vanilla, and eggs in this smaller bowl. Now, since we're making a double recipe, we need to put in 4 cups of milk. Okay, now it's time for the eggs, and I've got my little custard cups here to break them into so I can look out for those shells.
Nobody likes crunchy Mickey waffles.
And there we go, 4 large eggs. Now we just need 4 teaspoons of pure vanilla extract. Now we're going to whisk these ingredients up together, and then we'll be adding it to our dry ingredients. Now just make sure you get all those eggs mixed in there and the vanilla, and you should be set to go. Then we're going to pour these together. I hope I have enough room. Okay, it looks pretty well mixed up there, so I think we're set to go. Okay, now the question at hand, do I have enough space in this bowl to add the wet ingredients? Let's find out. Are you crossing your fingers? Here we go, here we go, here it comes. Oh my gosh, it's getting full. Okay, I made it, just made it. Wow, that was too close. Okay, now it says to use an electric mixer, and I will, but first I'm going to very gently mix it up by hand, making sure not to let anything go splashing out of the container here. When you make a double recipe, make sure you have a very large container. Now, I don't want to start mixing it up too much because I need to add the butter. I need to add the butter to this, and that would be 12 tablespoons of butter. I know, so many ingredients into a very small bowl here. 12 is the biggest bowl I have. 12 tablespoons of butter I'm going to melt, and then I'm going to put it in here. And here are 12 tablespoons of butter, and then that's the end of the ingredients. No more, so we're set. Just like that. I'm gonna continue mixing it up here for just a little bit, and then I have to use the electric beater to mix it all together. I think we're out of the danger zone here. Most of the dry ingredients have been fully engulfed in the wet ingredients. Okay, here we go. Electric beater at the lowest possible setting on a very full container. Low. It's working! Now it's very, very important with this mixture not to overmix it. You really have to be careful just until they're combined. As soon as they're fully combined, stop mixing, otherwise you can overdo it. And then the waffles don't taste as good. You want them magical. So we're gonna mix just a small amount more, just with the electric, just a little bit more, even by hand, just to double check that it's all mixed together, and then we're gonna start making those waffles. And now it's time to make those waffles. We're gonna set these ingredients right over there, grab our waffle iron, which is fully heated up at this point, the Mickey waffle iron. We're gonna open it, and we're gonna brush it with a little bit of butter just to give it that first coat, and then we're gonna add our first batch of waffles to it. Now we're just adding a little bit of butter here, just a little bit, just to grease it up, just to, oh my gosh, don't lose that, uh-oh. All right, we're good, we're fine. There we go. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I'm fine. Okay. A little bit of butter. We're okay. Woo. That's hot. And the ears right there. Now the first waffle we put in here is going to look a little weird. First one's always a little weird. That's how it works in this iron anyway. Don't let it discourage you. Just the first one is usually just kind of like a sample. It's for the chef to taste. It's, you know, it's the benefit of cooking these things. So let's put that first waffle right in the waffle iron. You ready? Here we go. Put it right in the middle, fill in some of those ears just a little bit, just like that. Spread it out. You don't want it to be too full or it's going to overflow everywhere. Then you're going to close it up, as soon as I fill in this ear, just like that. Can you see that? It's relatively filled in well, but not too much. Now we're gonna close it up and give it about 3 minutes, 2.5 minutes. It really depends on your waffle maker. It's already smelling amazing. Like I'm already smelling that deliciousness. Obviously, I can't give you an exact time for how long to cook the waffles because it depends on the waffle iron that you have. This one's really old, so sometimes it's inconsistent, but I love the shape so much, I can't get rid of it. Cannot get rid of it at all, but it really depends on how you like the waffle too. If you like it a little bit softer, not as long. If you like it a little bit more crunchy, then longer. It really depends on your taste. Now, making a double recipe, let me tell you, is going to make a ton, I mean a ton of waffles, but they're gonna be delicious. They're gonna be absolutely delicious. I've got a lot of people around me who are going to love them, so that's gonna be great, but it is a lot, so just be aware of that. I don't think you can buy these waffle irons anymore. I'm pretty sure it's a different shape Mickey. My mom and dad bought it when I was a little kid and they wanted to bring the waffles back home. That was, I mean, I'm so glad we have this in our family. This is a great waffle maker. Okay, that might be just about perfect for our first waffle. Take a look at this. Usually I use two forks, just kind of put right in the side here. Make it easier to take it out of there. Look at that! We've got our first Mickey waffle. And again, it looks a little inconsistent because it's the first one. That's just something to be aware of. The first waffle is always a little inconsistent. Let's keep on going, buttering a little bit as we go along. Okay, here we go with our second waffle here. We're putting it right in the center, moving it to the ears a little bit, making sure it fills in all the way. Now here we go. I just wanted to show this to you. It's not quite done. You see how that is right there? It's not quite done. It needs to be a little bit darker, just like this one is right here. It's not quite there yet. I'm gonna close it back up, but I just wanted to give you a little preview of how it looks before it's, you know, further done. Okay, let's take a look at this next waffle. Oh my gosh, it's looking great. Take a look at this. I'm gonna use my little forks here. There we go with our first Mickey waffle. Again, a little inconsistent. That's a buttering thing. I will work that out, but let's give it a try before I make the rest of them. Now you can see there are little edge pieces here, and that's not a bad thing. Those are great for little snacks. I'm gonna move it aside there so you can see both Mickeys right there, the first one and the second one right there. Let's put a little, you know what, should we put maple syrup on it? Let's not. Let's give it a try without maple syrup first. And you know, the first place I want to try it is right at the ears. Bon appetit. Let's give it a try together. Oh my gosh. That is, oh my gosh, so good. So good. Really reminding me of those magical memories. The place that I think of immediately is Chef Mickey's. When I take a taste of Mickey waffle, first place I think of, Chef Mickey's. Now, the only thing we need is a little bit of maple syrup to top it off right there. I'm gonna put it right on the ear. There you go, perfect. And I'm just gonna eat just a little bit. I know I should be eating with a fork and knife here, but I wanted to, you know, give it a little try because I'm pretty impatient for Mickey waffles. Here we go. Love it. The only thing that you might want to think about changing is the amount of malted milk. It depends on your taste. If you want more, if you want less, you can always change that up later. But I usually start with 5 tablespoons. I might add another tablespoon as I make a few more of these waffles. Now these are fantastic, but now I'm going to make the rest of the waffles. Let's do it. And here we go with our finished Mickey waffle. You see it right there. It looks fantastic. It tastes just as good as it looks. But of course, that's not the only Mickey waffle I made. When I made a double recipe, look how many waffles I have here for breakfast. friends and family close to home. Thank you so much for being a part of the magic with me today. It was so much fun to make this recipe for you. They were absolutely delicious. I did change one small piece as I was making them. I added a few more tablespoons of the malted milk powder, 3 more tablespoons total, just to get a little bit more of that malted taste. They taste perfect. Let me know if you give them a try in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. Thank you so much for being a part of the magic with me. Until next time, woohoo, here we go. Have a magical day.